Hey, how you doing? Make sure you get me in the middle there. All right. This is David. Welcome to David's Kitchen. We're going to make hot Italian sausage, peppers, and onions sandwiches. And I'm going to start out first. I'm just going to put a little bit of EVOO in the frying pan. Get the frying pan lit. Come on, stove. Sometimes the stove likes being stubborn. That should have lit it. All right, we'll end up closing the doors and the windows. But I got these spicy hot Italian sausage. And I found the best way to get these is to take them and cut them like into little meatball sizes. They cook up great. And you can mix up the peppers and the onions in there with them and fit more into the sandwich. I'm gonna go ahead and cut these up, and I'll get back to you after I get my peppers and onions. I still gotta wash them and de-seed them. So I'll get back to you here shortly. All right, welcome back. Just for a second, I'm showing you that they cook up nice and firm without falling apart because I've cut them into like little meatball shapes. That way it makes them easy to flip around too. Decoring your peppers, I just take and push in, spread it apart, and here's the little piece with all the seeds that you don't need. I'm going to save those because I'm going to dry them out. But once again, push it in, tear it in half, pull out your grove seeds. Really easy. Push it in half. There's your seeds. It's okay to leave a few seeds in there. They're not going to hurt anything. But I take, I'll show with the red one. Into strips about like that. And because I love raw veggies, Ghost. The ghost and Mrs. Muir just came in. Alright. Give these a little bit of a... You can see how they're shaping up like little meatballs. Once these are cooked, I'll set them in a bowl and set them aside. Because I'll end up cooking the peppers, onions, garlic, a little sea salt, and fresh ground cracked pepper. I got these rolls. And I'm going to be doing those with a mayonnaise, olive oil, cracked pepper kind of brush on. And that's the side I'll be grilling. It gives a little extra flavor to the inside of the sandwich. But these are going to be delicious. I'll get back to you later. Okay. What I love is, once again, let me get these. It's okay to get them slightly burned. Gives them a little extra flavor. But I like the array of color. I got the red bell peppers, the green, the yellow. Got my onions here. And what I do is I slice them into thin slices. Some people like a lot more onion, but I figure we got enough peppers and the onions together. Some minced garlic, little sea salt, and fresh ground peppercorns. I'll get back to you here. I'm gonna separate the meat now from the pan, and I'm gonna set it aside. I guess I can do that while you can watch this. Put all the little sausage right there. Now what I want to do is I'm going to throw the onions in the bottom first. There's some little leftover EVOO in the bottom. I might throw in just a little bit more. But after these onions start cooking down a little bit, and I like garlic. That's about a tablespoon of garlic. And all these peppers and onions, they'll all end up cooking down. And this is just gonna be so good. Peppers, onions, sausage. After these get all cooked down, what I'll end up doing is I'll put the meat back in there to reheat the sausage. Hot Italian sausage, peppers and onions. Then we'll get them rolls all greased, all lathered up, thrown on the grill. I need to dry my hands. I don't want to get ground sea salt. Just go around it once or twice with a little sea salt. And a few times with some. By the way, there's a setting inside the cover. When you pop this cover off, there's a little setting here. You can use coarse or fine. For when I'm cooking like this, I like using coarse. Same thing with the sea salt. I like to get a little bit of a bite. I like to feel it and taste it at the same time. Now we'll just give this a little shake. Put just a drop more of EVO on there, EVOO. That way nothing burns, whatever does burn or caramelize. We'll just give it a flip. I'll get back to you after these cook down a little bit. We're going to do a little olive oil, mayonnaise, and cracked pepper. And that's how we're going to, that's what we're going to put on the bread to grill the insides of these rolls. Now, everybody else uses exact measurements and all that, but I don't. I pretty much go by what feels right. And since, you know what, since I'm only going to be making enough for a couple of sandwiches, we'll probably end up taking the rest of this on the truck with us.
It's about a half a cup of mayonnaise.
Yeah, and a little bit of EVOO. Probably about a tablespoon and a half. And some cracked pepper. You can see that it's coarse. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix this up. I'm going to stick it in the fridge while the other stuff is cooking. And this will set in the fridge and kind of let the flavors involve into one another. This is a lot healthier for you than butter, which is the normal way to do it. But and this will just give it a little extra tangy flavor. All right. Take a saucer instead of wasting some of the wax paper, aluminum foil. I'll just place the saucer on top, stick it in the fridge. Because it's got all them flavors, the mayonnaise and the cracked pepper and the EVOO is going to intermingle with one another. And I'm cooking on relatively low flame. I'm simmering, which means they're going to take a little while to cook down and caramelize. I could cheat. You know what? For the sake of the video, I will cheat. Where's the cover for my frying pan? My frying pan cover is missing. Head down. Papa Chuck, there it is. Alright. Grandpa Chuck and Nuts was about to get upset. Couldn't find the cover. I'm going to cover them. It's nice and hot over here in Illinois today. It's like 90 degrees and humid as heck. So, it's making moisture come out of everything. You see me sweat? The moisture's coming right out of me. So, I'm going to let that cook down a while. I'll get back to you in a little bit. Alright, welcome back. Okay, as you can see, the peppers and the onions, they have cooked down. Doesn't look like there's so many peppers and onions now. But, yeah, they're nice and cooked down and hot. Very slightly caramelized. Very slightly. So now what I'm going to do is take the sausage that we cooked earlier and put it back in there. Let the sausage get hot. And I'm going to break this out. This is a little grill. I love this thing. But you put it over both burners, just like that. And you can turn on both burners and it cooks like an outdoor grill. Anyway, let me get this cover out of the way. Okay. And we got the rolls. And I got French rolls. Italian French rolls. Remember that little stuff I mixed up a little while ago? Olive oil, peppercorn, and mayonnaise. And put some of that on there. This is in place of butter. This is how we're going to grill the bread. And what you do is you just take it and you put it right on there. And I'll get back to you just as soon as these are toasted up. Because these are going to be some good peppers and onion sandwiches. Alright. Here we go with the first one. You see how that roll is just grilled right up? I'm going to line up some peppers on here. And we'll take some of the peppers and onions. Get one of them red peppers on there for the color. And give that a little swish. Turn that section off. So, we got a beautiful sandwich and a Bud Light with lime.
Tell them I'm coming.
Lunch is served. There you go. And now you can turn the camera off.